What's good, everybody? DB, the producer here, and I just got something that I want to talk to y'all about. So I've been seeing a lot of comments about Native Instruments expansions and how like people really don't know what to do with them. I do want to show y'all how to break down these Native Instrument expansions, man. I mean, they got a lot within them. Like, so I'm gonna go here to Satin Looks, right? Let's click on up in here in Satin Looks. So within Satin Looks, right, the deep feeling, smooth and soulful sounds of R&B evolution from the late 80s until today. Classic keys, you know, chopped up chord progressions, classic synth styles, and crisp acoustic percussion. 60 battery and 50 machine kits full of lush chops, warm bass, and original sample instruments, right? So you can go ahead and listen to the audio demo to kind of get a feel for what the sounds may sound like. But here's what I want to show you guys, right? So here, this tells you what comes within any expansion that you want to purchase. So this one, as you can see, samples and loops, 395 loops, 469 drum samples, 142 one shots. Now let's go to the drum kits. You get 60 battery kits and 50 machine kits. Not only that, synth presets. So you get 5 Monarch presets and 10 Micro Prism resets. Presets. But then as an exclusive machine owner, like I got the MK3, or if you got the Micro or the Machine Plus or any machine hardware, you get 200 patterns, 1 bass synth preset, and 8 projects, right? Additional information, as you see, the drum samples is 141 hi-hats, 86 percussion, 69 snares, 87 kicks, 25 claps, 41 cymbals, and 20 toms. At A, installer size of 1.72 gigabytes, right? So I wanted to show y'all this because a lot of people really don't understand what comes with your expansions, right? And I specifically look at this one because it's an R&B, and I'm going to go inside a machine and show you everything that it has to offer. So look, first, I'm in my first category, projects, right? I'm in projects. So projects, it said it had 8 projects. So here are my project files, right? So let's load this up. Now, this is the project. Now, within the projects, it may look like chaos, but if you use machine to make beats, then you understand what you're looking at. But for those who do not understand, so at the top are your scenes, and down here are all your patterns, and here are all your groups, right? So this is how they arranged their beat. Let's take a listen for a sec. That's a lot. Yeah, that's a lot. So check this out. This is your project, right? So if you really want to understand what you're viewing right now, I am in the song mode, right? Song mode. But right here, I can flip it to ideas mode, right? So here at the bottom is all your groups, and up here is all your patterns. Now at the very top is the scenes. So right now they only have 4 scenes: intro, verse 1, verse 2, and hook. And if I go back to the song, intro, verse 1, verse 2, and hook. And how they arranged it was, right now they got the intro highlighted, And then they put in the patterns of the specific groups that they wanted to play during the intro. So as you see, we got the drums highlighted, perk 2 highlighted, perk 3 in the intro. Then we also have strings in the intro and the bass in the intro. And if I go back to the arrange, I'm to the song view, that's what we have: drums, perk 2, perk 3, intro, and the bass. So that's how they arranged it. Now, personally, I wouldn't do anything with their projects. This just goes to show you what Machine is capable of. That's the purpose of these projects, I feel. So yeah. And not only that, like for how they did it, right, or pretty much all the instruments, they are in a loop form. So as you see, it's a bells, 89 BPM. And I don't know what key this in, but it's a something minor. Let's see. C sharp minor, right? And then they got the name of the loop. So most of these are audio loops. Keys, 123, 123 BPM, D sharp minor. This is how they structured their beat. So these are the projects, and all the projects come like this. So let's go to the next one. She say she falling in love. Let's take a listen to this. So that is the project section, right? Next, I'm going to go to the kits, right? So let's start a new one. So now I'm in the kits. Now the kits has a special place in my heart because these must sound amazing. Not only that, they have a lot of routing options that they put together and you are able to use. But then not only that, they got patterns as well. Check this out. All right, cool. So let's say I pull this in. Now look, down here at the bottom, right, you have routing and you have patterns. Now, I'm going to load it in with no routing and no patterns, just the samples. If I double click, boom, here is my drum kit. And this is everything that is within this kit. Now, check this out. If I load it in again and I do patterns, let's reload it. Now, if I get up out of the mixing, now you see all the patterns within this drum kit, right? So, check it. So yeah, those are the patterns that come with the drum kits. But then not only that, say you wanted to add routing as well. So if I double click this, boom, there's my routing. My effects, how they have so routed, right? They got one bass synth preset. If I load it up, here is the bass preset. Satin looks have loops. And if you watch my last video, here are some of the ones that I like. Some of the loops, and you can play around with them. As you watch my last video, you can put them in, chop them up, reverse them, flip it, pitch them up, pitch it down, do all that stuff to make it yours, right? Not only that, then you have the one shots. As you can see, bass one shots, bow strings, bow strings, I'm tripping, bow strings one shots, drums, a lot of drums. A lot of drums, guitar, percussion. Like, do I need to go on? Like, all this stuff that comes with the expansions. I can build out my own kits, you know, based off what they give me. You got piano one shots, you got a whole bunch of different one shots. Like, ooh, that chord was crazy. Bro, like, it's just so much that you can do with this stuff, bro. Alright. But anyway, man, thank y'all for tuning in, bro. I just wanted to show y'all how to use Native Instruments expansions, man. I just reading some of these comments, man, and looking at some of these other expansion videos, bro. Like, for people really saying that they feel like they gotta be a rocket scientist to like explain to understand these mods. Like, it's not really that hard. Y'all just need help understanding what to do with them and how to look at them. So yeah, man, if y'all need more help, man, just hit me up. My email will be in the description. I'll say it here as well: dbtheproducer, thaproducer @gmail.com. thanks for tuning in. Hey, be sure to go to buy me a coffee and purchase my Red Rust effect pack. As you watched my last video, some of these little sounds and textures and movements and reverbs I pull directly from the presets that I created, and these mugs sound chef kiss, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, be sure to do that, man. Thank y'all for tuning in. I'll see y'all later.